Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Apple, which unveiled a current quarter revenue outlook that missed the top end of Wall Street estimates. This in a possible sign of caution ahead of the holiday season. Apple shares are down 1% before the bell. Also in focus, shares of Amazon, as strength in its cloud and advertising businesses propelled its earnings past Wall Street expectations. Amazon shares rallied 6% on the news. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Maersk after both Barclays and JP Morgan increased their target price for the stock. Shares of the Danish shipping giant jumped 3.7%. We're also keeping an eye on Reckitt Benckiser of the UK consumer goods firm was cleared of liability in a baby formula case. Its stock surged nearly 9% in midday trading. Well, Asian markets kicked off November on a sour note as U.S. election uncertainty weighed on sentiment. The Nikkei 225 led declines as a stronger yen hurt the outlook for Japanese exporters. The Shanghai Composite also fell, even as a private sector survey showed factory activity returned to expansion in October. But that news sent the Hong Kong Hang Seng rising nearly 1% to buck the regional downswing. Now, in notable stock movements in the region, shares of Chinese developer Yuzhu Group plunged 25%. That's after the debt-strapped firm announced a $1.5 billion rights issue plan to support its proposed debt restructuring plan. Meanwhile, Li Auto saw its Hong Kong listed shares stumble 9.5% as it provided weak fourth quarter sales guidance. Market analysts are gearing up for what they've called index-bearing events in November, such as the crucial U.S. polls. The Managing Director for Equity Capital Markets at Investment and Capital Corporation of the Philippines, Manny Ocampo, says the U.S. elections will impact the Philippines in the sectors of trade and services exports. Ocampo anticipates Republican nominee Donald Trump may be more aggressive with his policies if he returns to the White House. The chief equity strategist of DA Market Securities, Nisha Alicer, also notes both investors and the market as a whole might benefit more if Democrat Kamala Harris secures presidency.
If you're talking about long-term performance of the market, it actually matters less if it's Republican or Democrat, at least for the U.S. markets. However, it has been seen or observed that many of the other jurisdictions around the world actually prefer Harris win because she's been more consultative and takes a multilateral approach. As we've seen in his previous presidency, he had taken a more competitive stance against China. And I think what Asia is concerned about is a higher tariff environment in a Trump win.
The ASEAN region continues to emerge as a winner of increasing geopolitical tensions between China and the U.S. That's according to the International Monetary Fund. The IMF said the region has long benefited from decades of globalization, building strong trade links with the world's two largest economies. It adds, as U.S.-China relations deteriorated in recent years, the 11-member bloc has adapted and continued to integrate with the global economy. The UN agency, though, warned escalating trade tensions as well as China's property crisis could hurt the whole Asian region. The IMF explained a longer and larger than expected slowdown in China would be harmful for both the region and the global economy. It now urges Beijing to take steps to achieve a more demand-driven recovery for its economy.